Just a quick note regarding your diet. As you know, it takes energy to be able to walk with your new prosthesis. If you will make sure that you have a well-rounded diet and drink plenty of fluids, this will assist you in walking better. If you have any specific questions regarding your diet, please contact your primary care physician.
This is called prosthetic limb stepping, and it will help you learn to walk properly. You may want to use a railing or chair for stability. You'll step with your prosthesis, and your other leg will stay in place. Begin by standing with your prosthetic foot behind you. Focus on pushing off with the toes. Swing your leg through. And when your prosthetic foot comes back down, hit your heel first, then distribute the weight to your residual limb. Reverse the step to return to the starting position. As you do this exercise, your stride length should be the same as when you walk. This is a quadruped strengthening and balance exercise. Begin on your hands and knees. Lift your left arm and right leg at the same time. Hold this for 3 seconds, then return to the starting position. Now, lift your right arm and left leg. Again, hold for 3 seconds. Rest briefly between repetitions. This is a static standing balance exercise. It will help you safely balance equally on both legs. You'll need 2 high-backed chairs. Position the chairs, one on each side, with the chair backs facing you. Hold on to the chairs and position your feet shoulder-width apart. Gradually lift your hands. Remember, balance equally on both legs. Avoid favoring one side over the other. In this exercise, you'll be reciprocally walking stairs, which means you'll be walking step over step. This method usually applies to below-knee amputees. Whether going up or down, focus on controlling your residual limb. Walk up a stairway, starting with your prosthesis. Once your prosthetic leg is safely planted on a step, bring your sound limb up past your prosthesis and place it on the next step. To walk down a stairway, start with your sound leg. Remember, always have control of your prosthesis before moving your other limb. Practice using the handrails at first, but work toward walking stairs without them. This method of walking stairs is called a step 2 pattern, and it's primarily for above-knee amputees. Whether going up or down stairs, focus on controlling your residual limb. When stepping up, start with your sound leg, then bring your prosthesis up to the same step. Repeat this for each stair. Do not walk step over step, as this may cause you to lose your footing. You'll walk down the stairs in a similar way. This time, start with your prosthesis. Then, once you have control, bring your sound limb down to the same step. Repeat this, prosthesis, then sound limb, for each stair. Practice using the handrails, but work toward walking without them. For the stool scoot, you'll need to find a rolling chair and a large area of open, flat, and hard flooring. Push yourself backward across the floor. Then pull yourself forward to your starting position. You'll find pulling forward more difficult, so it's important to dig in with your heel. Contracting your hamstrings, the muscles on the back of your leg, is what allows you to pull. When pushing backward, again, dig in your heel. When you push, you'll be working your quads, the muscles on the front of your leg. This variation of the crunch focuses on your lower abdominals. Lie on your back with your knees bent. Raise your upper body and your lower body at the same time. Make sure to tighten your lower abdominal muscles. Hold for 5 seconds, then relax. Breathe throughout the exercise. In this demonstration, you'll learn the proper way to walk up and down an incline. Start by walking down an incline. Control your residual limb while swinging your sound side to take a step. Avoid quick motions. Instead, focus on keeping movement smooth and even. Allow your quads and hamstrings to strengthen during this exercise. Now practice walking up an incline. Again, control your residual limb while swinging your sound side to take a step. Avoid a quick extension of the residual limb knee. Smooth motion is the key. Use your arms for support if you need it. Allow your legs to strengthen. When walking up an incline, you may notice the toe of your prosthetic dragging. Try not to let this happen, as it may cause you to trip.
The home exercise program that you have just seen is the core of your physical therapy rehab. Needless to say, we can't show you everything here, but if you have any questions or concerns, please don't hesitate to contact us.